Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I will be doing another sunscreen review. I'll review the Pipette Baby Mineral Sunscreen Broad Spectrum SPF 50. But before I get into today's review, if you love all things skincare, make sure you subscribe because that's all we do on this channel. Let's get into the review. I will first go briefly over the brand, talk a little bit about it and a little bit about the ingredients and the product, and then I will show you a demonstration of me applying it on my face and then how it sits under makeup. So let's talk a little bit about the brand. The brand is called Pipette or Pipette Baby. On their Instagram, they are called Pipette Baby. So I'm a little bit confused. But anyway, this is a sister brand of the skincare line Biossance. They are both under the same parent company. Pipette seems to focus a lot on baby products. However, I do think now they are trying to reach a bigger audience as they have recently released an exfoliating treatment. And I would like to think that's not made for babies, it's made for adults. However, this sunscreen is safe to use for babies of 6 months old or older. This sunscreen uses only one active ingredient, and that is zinc oxide. It's got 20% of it in the formulation. It comes in 120 ml or 4 fluid ounces, and it retails for $12. Definitely very affordable, especially if you'd compare it to Biossance. It is fragrance-free, and it says here it's non-toxic and clean, so I would hope so. Definitely very affordable considering the price. A regular size of a sunscreen is around 2 fluid ounces, and here you're getting double of that. I got mine off of iHerb. That was the only way I could get it shipped to me, and I believe I paid around $10 for it, even though it retails for $12. I was able to use some coupon codes and get a little bit of a discount. This is not just very affordable, but the entire family can take advantage of it. One thing to note though, this is not water resistant. So if you're going to the beach, if you're going to be swimming or sweating, you do need to use another sunscreen. I had a quick look at the ingredient list. It's quite minimalistic. The only thing that I saw noteworthy to call out is that it's got a base of squalane, which is very nice on the skin. It absorbs quickly and it is an emollient. But the brand does call out the inclusion of wild gooseberry extract in it, and they do claim that it minimizes the effects of infrared light. However, I tried to do a little bit of research and I couldn't find whether that claim was true or not. So just take that with a grain of salt. You will be seeing me right now applying it on my skin on camera. As you can see, it does come out as a white lotion, and when you put it on the skin, it goes on very smoothly. It does spread really nicely. You can definitely tell that it's got that squalane in it. It does have a little bit of a white cast, but it's not as bad as many other mineral sunscreens. On my light skin, you can see it kind of dissipates and almost disappears into my skin. While I will say, you can still definitely see it a little bit. So if you've got anywhere between medium to deeper skin tones, you will definitely see a white cast, but that's the case with any mineral sunscreen. I waited around 20 minutes to see if it would absorb into my skin and if that sticky finish would kind of disappear. However, I was still able to feel that stickiness even after 20 minutes, but I will say it's not heavy or uncomfortable. You can't really feel it on your skin, but if you were to touch your face, you would definitely feel that it's sticky. So after 20 minutes, I went ahead and I applied my makeup, and I would say my makeup sat on top of it just the way it does with any other mineral sunscreen. And what I mean by that is that I had to work with it in a specific way to make it work on top of my makeup. I generally apply my makeup on top of my mineral sunscreen using a beauty blender because I don't want to disturb that film that the sunscreen has created on my skin. And I had to blend a little bit more than usual to make it really stick to certain parts on my face. But with a little bit more blending, it did end up looking quite nice, and I really didn't face any issue with it later on during the day. But I do want to note that around the nose area and the pores on my cheeks, it did create that white polka dot look. But again, with further blending, it did end up looking quite fine. As you could see from my application video, upon applying it, it did look a little bit greasy. However, once I put on my makeup and set it with powder, that greasiness completely disappeared and it didn't reappear throughout the day as it is with some other sunscreens. I do want to also note that this sunscreen did not sting or burn my eyes upon application, and even throughout the day I didn't notice any stinging or discomfort in my eyes. And usually a lot of sunscreens do that to me. Some of them not upon application, but throughout the day I do notice that my eyes start to burn and I kind of get like a headache, but this one didn't do any of that, and I really appreciate that about a sunscreen. So as a conclusion, I think this is a wonderful family sunscreen. It is fragrance-free, cruelty-free, suitable for babies, SPF 50, mineral sunscreen, all of that. It's got really cute packaging, it is very affordable, and you do get a decent size. Also, the white cast isn't very bad, especially considering that it's purely mineral sunscreen. So I think it ticks a lot of boxes, and a lot of people are going to enjoy it. A lot of moms are gonna want to get this because it looks good on them and it protects their babies. So a great option, a lot of people are going to enjoy it. And if you've been eyeing it and you weren't sure whether you should pick it up or not, I think you should. That's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. I have reviewed quite a few sunscreens on my channel. I will leave a link to my playlist in my description box. Make sure to check it out. Wherever you are in the world, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Subscribe to my channel for my future content, and I will see you in my next one. Bye guys.